Hi everyone. I am Shreshth Tuli, a President's PhD scholar at the Department of Computing, Imperial College London. And in this video, I'll present a recent work titled COSCO, Container Orchestration Using Co-Simulation and Gradient-Based Optimization for Fog Computing Environments. This work was accepted as a research article at the IEEE Transactions on Parallel and Distributed Systems. So let me first talk about what fog computing is exactly, and how it is changing the lives of common people today. Fog computing is an emerging paradigm in distributed systems, which encompasses all intermediate devices between the Internet of Things, the IoT layer, and the cloud layer. It can drastically reduce latency of compute, network, and storage services by placing them closer to the end users, which is commonly called the edge of the network. This leads to a multitude of benefits like reduced latencies, lower costs, more reliability, and higher scalability. To put this in perspective, Netflix uses fog computing to possibly cache and process a popular video locally, which is then streamed to a nearby user, which no doubt leads to an amazing viewing experience. And for not so popular videos, they may be stored and processed in the cloud, leading to higher latency and, in some cases, poorer video quality. But one might ask, why don't we process everything at the edge? Considering that there are perhaps billions of edge nodes in close proximity to the users, with only thousands of cloud nodes accessible to all, it would become very expensive to run everything at the edge. To make deployments feasible, edge devices are often close to the user, but have limited processing capacities. On the other hand, cloud devices are far away, but can handle much heavier workloads, giving rise to this research field on how to carefully balance task placement to be within the latency demands of users, but also minimize deployment and execution costs. However, this problem of task placement is hard. One of the challenges we face in such a system is to deliver low latencies for time-critical applications. For instance, many industries, especially like healthcare, robotics, and smart cities, demand ultra-low response times specifically for tasks that are sensitive to the service level agreements or SLAs. Other applications, perhaps in an effort to drive towards a more sustainable model, involve energy scavenging methods and renewable resources. Using such energy sources leads to the requirement of supreme energy efficiency in task execution. The challenge, however, of reaching low response times and energy consumption is exacerbated by modern day applications, wherein the workloads are highly dynamic and host machines having non-stationary resource capacities. Prior work that uses heuristics, reinforcement learning, or other such methods solves these problems to a limited extent by sometimes not being quick enough to adapt to volatile settings, being slow to converge, or just that they can't keep up with the extreme user demands. This work aims at solving all these challenges to provide optimal QoS in fog environments. Before diving into the technical details, let me summarize the system model assumptions we consider in this work. We assume a scenario with multiple heterogeneous fog nodes in a master-slave fashion, which is a typical case in fog environments. We assume that the CPU, RAM, bandwidth, and disk capacities of each node is known in advance. And similarly, we can sample this resource consumption for each task in the environment at any time. Moreover, we consider that tasks include a batch of inputs that need to be processed by a host node. Further, for each task, a service level deadline or SLA objective is defined at the time the task is sent to the system. All tasks are received from an IoT layer, which includes sensors and actuators to collect data and send it across to the fog broker via the gateway device. The fog broker then decides where to allocate new tasks and where to migrate, if at all, the active tasks in the system. In terms of the workload, We divide the timeline into equal duration intervals and create workload tasks at the beginning of each scheduling interval using a Poisson distribution. Although our methods are agnostic to the specific QoS objective, in this work, we specifically aim to optimize popular parameters like energy consumption and response times using a convex combination of the two metrics. Considering the system model as discussed, we present two novel ideas to solve the problem of QoS efficient task placement in fog computing. Firstly, we leverage the strength of neural networks to accurately approximate QoS parameters. That is, we build a neural network-based surrogate model to approximate the objective functions. A surrogate model is an approximator that estimates values that are hard to obtain, for example, energy consumption in a distributed compute environment. Once we have this, we could use goal-directed gradient-based optimization schemes that tend to converge faster than the gradient-free schemes like genetic algorithms or reinforcement learning. Moreover, recent advances like root mean square propagation with momentum and warm restarts help prevent the problem of getting stuck at local optima. Thus, gradient-based optimization with such advances can be applied in tandem to provide an efficient solution for dynamic scheduling. However, simply using gradient-based optimization is not sufficient as data-driven neural models tend to saturate. This is when feeding more data to the neural model does not improve its performance. Further optimization of QoS in such cases is hard, and more intelligent schemes are required. Coupled simulation has shown to be promising here, allowing us to run a simulator in the background with the scheduling algorithms to facilitate decision making. A simulator could be used to virtually execute a sequence of decisions and observe how they affect the environment and consequently the objective scores. Through this, an optimum decision or a sequence of decisions may be obtained. Let me now present the first novel contribution of this work, that is the deep learning-based surrogate optimization. This is developed on gradient-based optimization using backpropagation to input with the acronym GOBI. Here, we use a neural network as a surrogate model to predict the QoS objective scores for a given state of the fog environment. We train such a neural network using supervised learning. To generate the data, we can run a random scheduler to cover as much of the state space as possible to create a dataset of ordered XY pairs, where X is the collection of scheduling decisions for each task, the resource utilization of all tasks and the host capacities available, and Y here is the value of the objective score for this particular state, that is X. We train the surrogate model fx, theta, where the theta is the set of weights of the neural approximator. We can train the model using, for instance, the mean square error between the predicted and true scores. Once the model is trained, at each scheduling interval, we take the input x and optimize it using the gradient of the neural approximator with respect to x using stochastic gradient descent. Now I will discuss the second novel contribution. As we just discussed, GOBI only uses the scheduling decision and other state metrics to predict the objective value at the end of the next interval, which is a very hard problem. To have a more accurate prediction at any instance, say t, we run the GOBI approach to get an estimate of what could be a reasonable scheduling decision. Also, we predict the utilization metrics of the next interval, say using an LSTM model. Now that we have a scheduling decision and utilization metrics, we can run a single step simulation that can give us another estimate of the QoS objective score. Now that we have one estimate from the GOBI's surrogate model and one from the co-simulation loop, we can get an idea of whether GOBI over or underestimates the QoS. Both these values are fed into an independent surrogate model, and the same optimization loop is run till convergence. This interactive dynamic between GOBI and the co-simulator is called GOBI star. GOBI star can make more informed predictions of the QoS metric for any interval and hence perform better than GOBI, albeit with higher overheads. To allow seamless co-simulation and integration of the simulator with the scheduler, development of a new interface is required. Hence, we developed COSCO, which stands for Coupled Simulation and Container Orchestration Framework, to leverage simulated results to yield better QoS. The COSCO framework allows a single or multi-step simulation of a container migration decision in fog environments. COSCO is implemented in Python and uses Docker containers to manage tasks. All communication among the host machines is via HTTP REST API. To preemptively migrate and restore containers in the environment, we use the Checkpoint Restore in User Space CRIU tool. The allocation and migrations are done in non-blocking fashion. That is, the execution of active containers is not halted when some tasks are being migrated. To run the Gobi Star model, COSCO provides the latest environment state to the surrogate models, runs the Gobi optimization loop till convergence, uses LSTM-based workload predictions, and Gobi's output to run a simulation trace. The QoS estimate of the co-simulation is then sent to the Gobi Star loop, and the final decision is executed. We evaluate the efficacy of the Gobi and Gobi Star methods on a Microsoft Azure-based fog deployment with 10 hosts. We consider a fog broker and 6 worker nodes at the edge, specifically for dual core and 2 quad core machines. In the cloud, we have 4 cloud worker nodes in a geographically distant location with 2 quad core and 2 octa core machines. We also consider a similar simulated environment scaled up 5 times to test how these algorithms perform in a large scale setup. For our baselines, we consider 2 heuristic based approaches, LRMMT and MADMC, 2 reinforcement learning models, DQLCM and A3C, a max weight based scheduler POND, and a genetic algorithm policy. For the simulated environment, the dynamic workloads are generated using the cloudlets based on real world open source BitBrain dataset. For the environments on the physical setup, we use the defog benchmarks to include diverse workload characteristics. These figures show the results comparing the Gobi and Gobi Star models with the baseline methods on the Azure platform with 10 hosts. As is apparent, both proposed models are able to outperform the state-of-the-art methods in terms of energy consumption, response time, and SLA violation rates. The bar graphs with different colors show the performance metrics for each application type in the defog benchmark. All the gains in performance are complemented by the low scheduling times of the proposed methods. This is primarily due to the goal-directed gradient-based optimization in our models. Similar trends are observed in the case of 50 simulated host machines. Additionally, we observe that the migration overheads of the proposed methods are low, and they are also able to schedule tasks in a fair manner. For more in-depth analysis and additional results, please refer to our paper. So to recap, this work proposed a novel scheduler, namely Gobi, which is based on gradient optimization using neural networks as a surrogate function. We then extend Gobi model to add co-simulated QoS estimates to further improve objective scores and call this the Gobi Star method. Comparing Gobi and Gobi Star against state-of-the-art schedulers using real-world fog applications, we see that our methods are able to reduce energy consumption, response time, SLA violation, and scheduling time. Between Gobi and Gobi Star gives better QoS values. However, Gobi is more suitable for resource-constrained servers. For the future, we propose to extend the COSCO framework to allow workflow models for serverless computing. Extending to serverless would allow us to perform fine-grained autoscaling, increase productivity, and improve flexibility and logistics. For the gradient optimization approach, currently we only restrict our deep surrogate functions to have fully connected layers with differentiable activations. We plan to extend our methods to consider other layer types like recurrent, convolution, or attention layers, with activations like rectified linear units, ReLUs. This would allow it to become more generalizable to other deep surrogate functions as well. Thank you for your kind attention. All our code implementation is available as open source GitHub repository with datasets and Docker images available on Zenodo and Docker Hub. The links are in the description of this video. For any queries, please feel free to send me an email. Cheers.